How do you know you should see a doctor for what could be a very minor knee injury? I'm Dr. David, orthopedic surgeon and sports medicine specialist, and I provide education, information, and commentary on all sorts of sports and exercise injuries, injury treatments, and injury prevention for athletes and active people so that you can stay healthy and perform your best. I get this question a lot. If you just look through the comments of most of my videos, there'll be a lot of questions about, do I need to see a doctor? And especially if you think, hey, this may not be a big deal. One, do you need to see a doctor? And two, can you continue to play sports or can you continue to exercise and see how it goes? In today's Ask Dr. Geier video, I answer that very question about basically whether or not somebody needs to see a doctor for what could be a fairly simple patellar dislocation. Katie asks, my kneecap popped out and back in just about that fast last night. It was painful, but not so much that I stopped playing volleyball. It's a little sore today, and I'm supposed to play again this afternoon. Will it cause additional damage to play through minor pain? And she highlights in all capitals, minor pain. And is that something that's serious enough that I should go see a doctor? Well, that's a great question, and there's not an absolute right answer. Here's my general thought, and you've probably heard me say this if you watch these videos a lot, on whether or not you should see a doctor generally for any kind of sports and exercise injury. If you can't do what you want to do as well as you want to do it, it's worth seeing a doctor. So if you try to go out and play volleyball and I just can't jump the way I want, or I don't feel confident on it, it never hurts to see a doctor. The worst thing, I mean, maybe you find out it's completely normal. Yeah, you wasted a little bit of time and maybe a little bit of money, but I wouldn't call that wasting because now you know you're not doing any harm to it. So that's one side of it. Typically, patellar dislocations, if it's just where it sort of slides out and back in and nobody has to pop it back in place or you didn't have to move it and pop it back in place, you might be able to get away with, you know, just seeing how it goes and trying to go again. If you do have a traumatic event where you have to pop it back in or somebody else does, that's a little bit harder to overcome. Tends to hurt more, tends to swell a lot more and get the knee really stiff. So that's something to think about. Maybe go see a doctor. Now, if you have a lot of those symptoms, your knee's big and swollen, that would potentially be worrisome. You know, maybe you knocked a little piece of cartilage or even bone off when the kneecap sort of popped out of place. You know, you can certainly tear ligaments and that could be why it's swollen. Or if you get back out there and it feels like it's really loose, I think it can be a good idea to see a doctor, maybe get x-rays or an MRI, maybe see a physical therapist. There's a lot of variables that go into patella dislocation. More often than not, somebody with a first-time patella dislocation doesn't develop repeated episodes, what we call recurrent instability, but that doesn't mean necessarily that it couldn't happen. So I think if somebody's not getting better pretty quickly, or if they have those signs that it could be a more serious injury, never a bad idea to go see a doctor. Have you dislocated your kneecap and did it happen again? What did you do to get over it? Did you see a doctor? I'd love to hear your experience, and I bet people dealing with kneecap dislocations all over the world would love to hear what you have to think as well and what you did about it. So below this video, share your experience. I'd love to read it, and like I say, I bet all of them would love to learn from you as well. If you like videos like this and you want more information on sports and exercise injuries and injury treatments and injury prevention, subscribe to my video channel. I record a couple of these videos every single week. Click the subscribe button in the upper right corner of the page and they'll get delivered directly to you. And if you have sports and exercise injury questions and you'd like me to answer them, I can't give specific medical advice, but I can at least answer the question in a general way. Send those my way and I'll try to answer them in an upcoming Ask Dr. Geier video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful and I look forward to seeing you right here next time.